Well, if you wondered why some plants prosper in some gardens but struggle pathetically in other gardens, like your own, then you may need to look no further than the soil below. Here to dish the dirt is well-known landscape designer and author Xanthi White. Morning, Xanthi.
Hi.
So this is your third book.
It is.
And when I first saw that you'd written a book called The Good Dirt, I laughed. I went, how can you write a book on dirt?
Yeah.
But you have written quite an interesting book on dirt.
Well, I felt quite passionate about writing this book on dirt. And of course, when I went to my publisher and said, I want to write a book on dirt,
they laughed at you, didn't
they? She felt exactly like you did. She was sort of like, and what's it going to look like?
So why did you decide to write it?
Because after, you know, more than 2 decades doing what I do, it's what people need to know. And so everybody starts talking about gardens like, what, pests and diseases and pruning and all this stuff above the ground. But if you don't get it right underneath, you're never going to get it right. And it's like, we start, everybody knows that when you start in the garden, you start digging a hole in the dirt. You plant your seeds, you plant your pot plants in the dirt. So doesn't it make sense that that's the first thing that you should get to know about?
What do you think New Zealanders like when it comes to the soil choices that are available? I mean, how different are we in different areas?
It varies greatly. And the thing that we need to understand about dirt is that we can change it, that we can grow it, that it's actually a living thing. And if we don't, if it's not in your dirt, it's not going to be in your food. So you can grow all this amazing food, but if it doesn't have, if it's not healthy, what it's growing in, it's, your food's not going to be that great either.
So how do you make healthy dirt then?
Yeah, you bring it to life. So it's all about putting back, just like everything in life, you know, like you've got to keep putting it back.
What, do you give it a green smoothie or something?
Yeah. Well, no, basically all that rubbish that's going out into landfills and stuff,
right,
putting it back into the ground, layering and taking time with your dirt. And also, it's about not disturbing it and thinking about what you do and how you create it. So this isn't just a book about gardening, it's also a book about landscaping, and it's full of some of the best landscapers in the world at this time.
That's what I was going to say. Yeah. It's not just piles of dirt in this book.
Oh, no.
There are some absolutely beautiful, there's how to sell a book. There's some beautiful gardens in
here. This is an amazing friend of mine, James Besson, who works in France, and I've got, you know, amazing Yosuke from Japan, and all the best designers in the world, I reckon, are in this
book. So your first book, Organic Vegetables,
yeah,
that was full of brilliant gardens as well. How do you find them? Are you just connected to a whole lot of really cool gardeners?
I'm kind of obsessed, and yeah, I've made sure that I'm like really good friends with all the best landscapers in the world.
Tough.
Travelled around and hit them, and I'm like,
do you
You're
find yourself driving down the road and if you see a really good garden, do you stop and have a look?
Yeah, I am quite obsessed. I remember once when I was young and I was at friend's flat and I was walking along the road, we were going down to see some band or something, and I was walking past and there was this huge weed growing out of someone's lawn, and I just, without even thinking, like pulled it out, and the person walked out of the front door and I was holding that weed and I dropped it and ran. Like, so like my level of interest in gardening is suddenly probably slightly abnormal.
Were you like my Nana when she used to go down the road with her clippers?
Yeah, I haven't gone that far yet.
Who are you? Yeah. Yeah. Nana, I'm so embarrassed. And they're just getting them.
And speaking of your love of, you know, plants and landscape, you started your own business at the tender age of 21, and everyone else is probably still finishing university, but you really believed in yourself. Was it something that you started at an even younger age, your drive towards gardening and landscaping?
I really just came to it, like, through, I guess it's something really creative and active and everything like that, but starting my own business was just because I was a girl, and so no one would give me a job. They told me I couldn't push the wheelbarrow, I wasn't strong enough to do the labouring work, and so I was like, well, buggy.
No. Yeah, I can do it. And you've proven time and time again that you actually have done it extremely well.
Yeah.
Because you've done so many, you've written the books, you've been on the TV, you've done so many things.
Mm. Yeah.
And who do you think, before we go, this is going to benefit? Are we talking farmers? Are we talking people with little gardens in the urban areas? Or is it everybody?
We're talking layers. So I think I'm a designer, so I think things need to work well. So there's like charts that you can just go, what do I add to my soil? Open it to a page. That's what you put in depending on your soil type. Or you can like read it and kind of get a real feel for it. Or you can just look at the pictures and be inspired.
Nice. Well, there is a lot of dirt in this country and in the world, so I'm sure everybody can relate to that book. I started reading the first part of the introduction, loved it. So I'm really excited to get my fingers on the rest of it.
Yeah, Xanthi, thank you so much. Xanthi's new book, The Good Dirt, is out right now. And if you're thinking of planting a new garden or you need a bit of help with the one that you've got, then make sure that you grab yourself. What are you talking about? You're looking at me, aren't you?
No, me. I'm going me.
You can look at both. And you can actually look at this whole studio. studio. Make sure you grab yourself a coffee.